Everyone, welcome back to the YouTube channel. Once again, haven't done a video in a while, but the difference is now off season's over and I've now started prep. So I'm now 12 weeks out. I'll show some photos of what I'm looking like at 12 weeks out. This morning weighed in at 113.7 kilos, which is like early 250s. Maybe like 251, 252 pounds. And then in 12 week time, I'll be competing in Classic, where my weight cap is 220 pounds, which is like 100 kilos. So yeah, about 30 pounds to lose over 12 weeks, which is like, in bodybuilding terms, very normal. And yeah, that's the starting point. At the moment, I'm on 3,500 calories on both training days and non-training days. The ratio of carbs to fat is slightly different on those days. Slightly higher carbs on training day, slightly lower carbs but higher fats on a rest day. And then what we're doing is periodically putting in high days. So yesterday was my first high day, which was about 4,600 calories, so about 1,000 calories more. Which in all honesty barely touched the sizes in terms of fullness. You know, for some people that sounds like a lot of food, but I was eating more than that in the off season every single day. So it's for me not that much food, but it was enough to like stimulate further fat loss. So I'm sure some people who are watching this are fans of bodybuilding, some people are bodybuilders themselves, some people have, you know, just are interested in what fat loss is and what it looks like. So I'll break down fat loss from like the bodybuilding perspective. Okay, so to lose fat, basically you've got to eat, the fundamental is eat less food than you're burning. So if you're burning through 2,500 calories a day, you want to be eating less than that a day. But the problem that you run into is that one, fat loss is not linear. So if you put yourself in a 200 calorie deficit, you're eating 200 calories less than you are, you know, to maintain that weight. Over time, over like a 16 week period or whatever, you're not going to just see a very steady fat loss like this. Okay, because for two reasons. One is as your body composition changes, your metabolic needs will change. So how your body uses energy and what it demands will change as, you know, you lose excess body fat, or maybe you gain lean muscle tissue or lose lean muscle tissue. So the demands will change. And the other reason is that your body is an adaptive machine. So think of evolutionary terms. Your body wants to find a spot it's comfortable at, where it can be like, yeah, I can survive at this. I don't need to change anything because I'm alive. So if you eat 200 calories less, eventually your body's going to be like, okay, I'm used to this eating 200 calories less now. I figured out a way to do it where I don't need to lose any more fat, where I don't need to lose any more muscle tissue. I can keep this human alive. So that's the kind of basic breakdown of why fat loss isn't simple, but it also is. If you have this information to hand, which you now do, because I've told you, then you can plan your fat loss phase better, so that you continue to lose fat whilst continuing to maintain the muscle that you've already built. So how do we do that? Now, as I said before, I've got training day food, rest day food, and high day food. So why do I have three different varieties of food throughout the week? Well, one, I want to be able to fuel my workouts so that I'm able to train as intensely as I was in the off season when I was gaining muscle tissue. That's a huge factor in bodybuilding. The other one is that if we know the body is going to try and adapt to whatever we're giving it, so 3,500 calories a day, it's going to try and adapt to that. So if we know that, we're like, well, how do we further stimulate fat loss then? And most people would say, well, just eat less food. Part of the problem with that is when you've got lean muscle tissue, is that if you're eating less and less food, how is that lean muscle tissue going to get a chance to function at 100% if you're not giving it the environment it needs to continue to be strong, to grow, to repair? So actually the answer is periodically eat more food, so like the high day stuff, to fill that muscle back out. So what do I mean by fill the muscle? What I mean is that lean muscle tissue is largely built up of water and glycogen. glycogen being carbohydrates you've eaten that your body's stored so that it can burn later down the line. So if you've got glycogen stored up, you know, like how they say, oh, if you're gonna go for a run the night before, eat loads of pasta, that kind of thing, that kind of, you know, thing you're taught in school but you don't really know what it means. That's the basic idea. So your body stores the carbohydrates as glycogen so you can use it as energy later down the line. So what we do as bodybuilders is we want to replenish the glycogen that we're burning from workouts so that when we work out the muscle again, it can still have the environment it needs to pull all the energy so it can contract as hard as possible, so we can break it down and then we can repair it again so that it's at 100%, i.e. it's not 90%. So then we come back, we're now training a muscle that's only repaired 90% and it's going to break down further. You can see how that cascade effect over time will mean that we're actually going to lose muscle because we can't train it as hard as we want to. And the reason muscle sticks around is because it's adapting to a stress, so we can't continue to show it that stress that we were able to. It's not going to stick around, your body's just going to get rid of it because it's quite easy to lose muscle. As anyone who's ever been to the gym and then had a little break from it knows, your muscle just disappears because it's got no reason to stick around. We need to give the muscle a reason to stick around. So we do that. We chuck a load of food on it every once in a while. And when I say a load of food, I don't mean cookies and burgers and pizzas and all that. There is a time and a place for that, but it is not right now. At the moment, just using clean, high food. So basically, the food I had yesterday was my exact diet as is, but with just slightly more rice, slightly more oats, slightly more ground rice. Very, very simple, easy way to just fill the body back up again. And like I said, fill that glycogen back up, so that when I go in training this week, I'm a bit fuller, I've got more energy to tap into, even though I'll be burning through body fat as the week goes on. So in a nutshell, that's kind of what it is. Over time, we'll taper down the amount of food being brought in, you know, as the body composition changes. So as I get leaner, but okay, there's not the demand now there was to 3,500 calories. Let's see how it responds on 3,100 or something like that. So, and then we can continue to further stimulate that fat loss and give the body a reason to want to get rid of that fat. On top of that, we can increase the expenditure. So at the moment, I'm doing 15,000 steps a day. When I'm at work, it's more like 20 to 30,000 steps a day whilst carrying stuff. So it's pretty tiring, but making sure I hit 15,000 every single day. And that's with 25 minutes of cardio in the morning, fasted. That's every day, and then my training sessions, which are 5 days a week, like chest day, back day, shoulder day, leg day, arm day. Very simple, nothing too complicated. And then yeah, so over time we're just gonna stimulate the fat loss by reducing the food, increasing the expenditure, but also increasing the food every once in a while, kind of waking the body's metabolism up, refreshing some of the hormonal cycles. You've got hormones that are responsible for your hunger, your sleep, your fullness, that kind of thing. Making, if they're over time, will also decline, so that, you know, you feel more hungry, you feel more lethargic, you feel more tired, you struggle to sleep properly. You've got to give the body a little reset, but like actually just keep functioning as you want to do, but we're just going to continue to lose fat. So, and then what happens is you'll notice that you'll put some food in, feel better, get some good workouts in, and then the body fat just starts to fly off again. Normally, if you're in too much of a deficit for too long without giving your body that break, fat loss slows a lot because your body is then trying to really fight to keep, it wants to keep hold of fat. Your body wants to keep hold of fat because, again, evolutionary based, body fat is what's going to help you survive. Like, your body needs body fat. We're trying to tell it the opposite. We're trying to say you don't need body fat. Even if it's just for a short amount of time, you don't need it. And that becomes easier the more you diet, the more lean muscle tissue you have, because you're kind of already convincing the body it doesn't need it. Talking about the body as if it's got some kind of cognition, it doesn't. Like, we just understand and can try and predict what it's going to do and how it behaves. So that's really it, really. 12 weeks out, looking pretty lean. Nice separation through the legs coming through, starting to see some of the tie-ins a bit more, like the glute hamstring tie-in, like through the arms, into the shoulder, into the pec, the lower pec. The waist is getting slowly tighter, the lower lat insertions are coming through a bit. And the main focus is going to be trying to keep the waist as small as possible, so doing a lot of work for the waist, which I'll go into in a later video. But I'm already aware that this ramble has gone for about 10 minutes already. So I hope that kind of clarifies what the plan is, what I'm doing at the moment. I could do a full day of eating if people want to see what I'm eating in a day. It is, like I said, it's very simple. It's nothing interesting. And yeah, the training is as intense as ever. The training hasn't changed at all. The training is exactly the same as it was. It's still brutal. It's still a lot of heavy lifting, because that's what built the muscle. So that's also what's going to keep the muscle. So there's no need to change how you train, even if you're on a diet. And there's no need to try and kill yourself too quickly as well whilst dieting. You want to ease into the diet, ease into it, ease into that fat loss stage. Keep the body as happy and healthy as possible whilst using some of that excess fat as an energy source. But yeah, thank you very much, guys. 12 weeks out till the first show, and that's 2 weeks before the first pro qualifier, which hopefully the only pro qualifier, but I've got a plan in place to, if I don't make it on the first one, there'll be more chances later in the year. But thank you for tuning in, guys. Like and subscribe, all that jazz, and see you again.